everyone back tonight with 1 Samuel chapter 4. It talks about the Philistines, who are, of course, the modern-day Palestinians over in the Gaza Strip, captured the Ark, which is the Ark of the Covenant. Now, the word of Samuel came to all Israel, and now Israel went out to battle against the Philistines and encamped at Ebenezer, the Philistines encamped at Aphek. The Philistines drew up a line against Israel, and when the battle spread, Israel was defeated by the Philistines, who killed about 4,000 men on the field of battle. And when the troops came to the camp, the elders of Israel said, "Why has the Lord defeated us today before the Philistines? Let us bring the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord here from Shiloh, that it may come up among us and save us from the power of our enemies." So the people sent to Shiloh and brought from there the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord of hosts, who is, of course, Jesus Christ, who was enthroned on the cherub, which are the two angels that rest on the covenant. And the two sons of Eli, Hophni, and Phinehas was there with the Ark of the Covenant of God. As soon as the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord came into the camp, all Israel gave a mighty about, so that the earth resounded. I'll read that again. As soon as the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord came into the camp, all Israel gave a mighty shout, so that the earth resounded. And when the Philistines heard the noise of the shouting, they said, "What does this great shouting in the camp of the Hebrews mean?" And when they learned that the Ark of the Lord had come to the camp, the Philistines were afraid, for they said, "A God has come into the camp." And they said, "Woe to us, for nothing like this has happened before." Because they never knew the one true God, Jesus Christ. Amen. "Woe to us! Who can deliver us from the power of the mighty gods? These are the gods who struck the Egyptians in every sort of plague in the wilderness." No, my friends, it wasn't God, plural form. For it was the one true God, Jesus Christ, that struck the Egyptians. Amen. "Take courage and be ye men, O Philistines, lest you become slaves to the Hebrews as they have been to you. Be men of fight." So the Philistines fought, and Israel was defeated, and they fled every man to his home, and it was a very great slaughter, for there fell of Israel 30,000 foot soldiers, and the Ark of God was captured, and the two sons of Eli, Hophni, and Phinehas died. The death of Eli. A man of Benjamin ran from the battle line and came to Shiloh the same day with his clothes torn and with dirt on his head. When he arrived, Eli was sitting on his seat by the road watching for his heart tremble for the Ark of God. And when the man came into the city and told the news, all the city cried out. When Eli heard the sound of the outcry, he said, "What is this uproar?" Then the man hurried and came and told Eli. Now Eli was 98 years old, and his eyes were set so that he could not see. He was pretty much blind. And the man said to Eli, "I am he who has come from the battle. I fled from the battle today." And he said, "How did it go, my son?" He who brought the news answered and said, "Israel has fled before the Philistines, and there has also been a great defeat among the people. Your two sons also, Hophni and Phinehas, are dead, and the Ark of God has been captured." As soon as he mentioned the Ark of God, Eli fell over backward from his seat by the side of the gate, and his neck was broken, and he died. For the man was old and heavy. He had judged Israel for 40 years. Now his daughter-in-law, the wife of Phinehas, was pregnant, about to give birth. And when she heard the news that the Ark of God was captured and that her father-in-law and her husband was dead, she bowed and gave birth, for her pains came upon her. And about the time of her death, the woman attending her said to her, "Do not be afraid, for you have borne a son." But she did not answer or pay attention, and she named the child Ichabod, saying, "The glory has departed from Israel, because the Ark of God has been captured because of her father-in-law and her husband." And she said, "The glory has departed from Israel, for the Ark of God has been captured." It's a very moving chapter right here, chapter 4. Now, they have the picture of the Ark of the Covenant, which we all know what that looks like, but here's a picture of it right here. See that right there? It's the Ark of the Covenant. Basically, it was a box, pretty much. So it was covered in gold, with golden poles and with gold angels, you know, looking at each other and bowing down to God. And now you have a map that says the ark's travel in 1 Samuel 3-7. After suffering losses in battle against the Philistines at Ebenezer, the Israelite forces called for the Ark of the Covenant to be brought to the battle from Shiloh, but the Israelites were defeated again, and the Philistines captured the Ark. The Ark's presence in each Philistine city caused people to suffer terrible tumors, so it was sent away to another city. Eventually, the Ark was returned to Israel at Beth Shemesh, and it was brought to Kiriath-Jearim, where it remained for some 20 years. Now, they have a map here. You have Philistia, which is modern-day Gaza today, the Palestinians. But, they started in Shiloh, and they battled at Aphek, went through Philistia, which is Gaza today, through Lod, over to Ashdod, over to Gath, up to Ekron, over to Beth Shemesh, over to Ajalon, and eventually over to Kiriath-Jearim. They gave the Jews back the Ark of the Covenant. Because what happened is, whenever the Philistines stole or took the Ark of the Covenant, it took God from Israel, and then God got so ticked off that he totally poured out his wrath upon the Philistines, in which then they brought our covenant back to Israel, where God would be. So that's chapter 4, and it talks about the Philistines capture the Ark, and the death of Eli, pretty much. And I'll be right back with chapter 5 here in a minute.